You said I was in my early 40s with a lot of life before me, when a moment came that stopped me on a dime. I spent most of the next days looking at the x-rays, talking about the options and talking about sweet time. I asked him when it sank in that this might really be the real end. How's it hit you when you get that kind of news? Man, what'd you do? And he said, I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu, and I looked deeper, and I spoke sweeter, and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. He said, I was finally the husband that most of the time I wasn't, and I became a friend a friend would like to have. And all of a sudden going fishing wasn't such an imposition, and I went three times that year I lost my dad. Well, I finally read the good book, and I took a good long hard look at what I'd do if I could do it all again. And then I went skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull named Fu Manchu, and I looked deeper, and I spoke sweeter, and I gave forgiveness I've been denying. And he said, someday I hope you get the chance to live like you were dying. Like tomorrow was a gift, and you got eternity to think about what you do with it. What did you do with it? What did I do with it? What would I do with it? Skydiving, I went Rocky Mountain climbing, I went 2.7 seconds on a bull.
Off ticket, so I went back to the counter and I bought two more with with it, and I won $10, and that was just right. So I bought a six pack and a bag of ice. You know, even if our ship came in and this is all we got, it ain't like we really need a $1 million yacht, 'cause we got an inner tube, we got a trailer. I'd go shoot tequila, take a lime and suck it, and we'd tell our bosses they can do the same. We'll find a big cruise ship and buy the whole dang thing. We'd sail around.